Hey, welcome back to another video. Today I want to show you how you can create sounds with just the filter of Bitwig Studio and the grid. And when we see here, we have an oscillator section where you can generate noise, or you can use the audio in and just put in some audio from outside of the grid. But you also can use here the random noise generator, which just generates some noise. So there's no output. So we need an ADSR here. Just connect that. So we have two types of noise here, white noise and the pink noise, which is more like an frequency distribution that matches your ear, where you would say, yeah, every frequency is exactly the same loudness. But technically it's white noise, but pink noise is more like, for the ear pleasing. And we have random noise across the whole frequency spectrum now. And to make music out of this, because this has no tonality, we need a filter. And this filter here, we have a lot of filters actually, but we need a filter with resonance. And I take this one here, and let's wire this up. So we now have a noise going into the filter, going into the amplitude modulation envelope here, and then we're going out. So this is, so sounds like we just cut off the high end of the noise. So exactly what's expected, right? But when you double click this button here, or this knob, and you can see the cutoff knob is jumping to 262 hertz, which is exactly, if you hover over this knob here and look in the bottom footer here from Bitwig, you can see it's exactly at C3, so the note C3. And that's for a reason, right? Because when you have here the pre-chord activated or the key track, that means that when you play the keys on your keyboard or have MIDI input into the grid going in, accordingly to the keys you are pressing, the filter is opening this knob here. You don't see it, but it's happening in the background. So the higher we go on the keyboard, the more the filter is opening. And when we now raise the resonance here until we have some ringing going on, we have now some kind of tonality, right? We have distortion or self-resonance. And when we press different keys, the filter's opening to the right frequency of the keys we are pressing. Then we have now some kind of a sound that we can play with. But you can still can hear some kind of noise coming through the filter. So it has some kind of special character. It sounds more like a flute or trombone or, I don't know, some kind of horn, for example. And you can even change how much noise and how much tonality you want with the filter resonance here. So for instance, when we take this envelope here and modulate the resonance a bit, so we have at the start more like a windy attack,
thank you.
And you can hear when I hold the note, it's not exactly, it's changing a bit because we are having white noise as an input. So it's not exactly a sine wave that we are generating. It's some kind, something in between, like a sine wave combined with a with the noise signal. So let's use some reverb here. So it's a pretty interesting concept to generate sound. You also can use all the other filters here, for instance, the low-pass LD. So every filter with resonance and key tracking is working. So it's just another way to create interesting sounds from noise. You can also change to pink noise. What you also can try is to not rely on C3, sondern just go in here and type C4, for instance, and leave the key track on. That should work too, but a bit differently because we have now offset the filtering via one octave. Also nice to generate some kind of percussions with tonality. Maybe use some shapers here, distortion. Yeah, maybe if you try to lay out with some other sounds, then it's becoming better. But yeah, that's just one example how you can create sounds without oscillators or the sampler or audio input. Just use the noise and drive it into the cutoff or the filter of Bitwig Studio. Use the resonance, play around a bit with the resonance values, and you get some interesting sounds out of it. Yeah, and that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please leave a like, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.